Hello. Hello, my friends. This is the day seven on my hunger strike near Ministry of Justice. I think I lost some weight this time. Still feeling spiritually strong, but quite weak. Thank you everybody for helping me. Much appreciate all help. I just want during this broadcast to appeal to Medway Council. I understand that Medway Council is going to prosecute me. Maybe put even a tag like they put on other parents' leg. So I want to tell Medway Council, till it is not too late, just leave my son alone. If you want, we can work and cooperate together to bring my son home. Because nothing will stop me. No any jails, no nothing. So you can carry on if you want to prosecute me, whatever you do. My cases became quite public now. And of course I try to comply with your injunctions, but if you think different, of course you can go to the court. If you go to the court in regards to prosecute me, at the same day I will issue my application to lift this injunction. You know pretty well that there is a petition already online which is asking to fire employees of Medway Council who are mistreating my son. I would like to remind you that my last contact with my son was stopped not as supervisor describes, not like Sarah Cahill describes that I called you Nazi in concentration camp. No. It was all different, and you have to know truth. And truth was that my son said he has problems with Russian language, and I said it's quite normal because he doesn't have his dad around, so no one can help him. And I said, when it's all over, when you come back to my care, we will all make it up what we lost. In this moment, Sarah Cahill said, just ordered me to stop and just carry on playing chess, you see? And I said, I did nothing wrong. I just want to encourage my son. That's all what I said. In this moment, she simply just stopped contact. You know that I'm on a hunger strike. I just drink water with lemon and that's all. Please think again, is it worthwhile to continue what you are doing? Because it's absolutely disgusting what you do. Your supervisor not only misled you, he also misled Guardian. Because she put totally different picture. She is manipulator. She is falsifying contact notes. She cannot stay in this job. She should stay somewhere in prison. Okay, I just want to use this to appeal to you, just to think again. You have your ways how you're doing things, so better we stop on this stage, because I want to see my son, and that's about it. I'm not going to beg you see him 4 times a year, 2 times a year, 3 times a year. Maybe you'll not allow me to see him at all. He's quite vulnerable now, and it's so cowardly that you're using that he's vulnerable. And you use my son just for the purpose of, for your own purpose, just trying to put him as a shield. It's extremely covered what you do. So I would like to appeal to Endomini just to think again, and better we cooperate in this stage, because no prison will stop me. No way. You know the Dutch embassy is going to come to court, and I do hope they will be allowed to be present. And please stop manipulating my son, because it will not help either. I will carry on with my hunger strike until I will get positive results from you. I hope I was enough clear. So just to show in our Ministry of Justice here. Petty Francis Street, St. James Park. Yes. Trying to, well, I hope professionals will recognize this location. Looks like it's here. A bit of dark, sorry. Sorry, I just want to. Yeah, it's fine. Sorry, I just wanted to say that. Okay, no worries, absolutely. Sorry for that. Just ask me to take my bag. Right, can't get this video of this Ministry of Justice, but anyway. It's a bit of dark. Ministry of Justice, yes. Right, now I will talk to my friends. Nothing more to add, no news from council. I do hope that you paid attention on my messages and about what I ask you. Couldn't sleep this night, you see. But it's okay. Just want to get Bible somewhere. Someone sent me some prayers. I have a court on Wednesday, as you know. So I believe if I lose this court, I will immediately appeal. I'll be in the Royal Court of Justice, and how long can person not to eat? I read somewhere without damage, serious damage to the health, just up to 2 weeks. That's what I was told. I just want to keep him in care, such an ambition, wasting money, government money. It's something, it's more than that. I don't believe they could be so anxious. Yes, you're absolutely right. Absolutely right. Absolutely. Natalia, you're absolutely right. He was so bitter, you know, when he said that, when we spoke about, well, Florin, I don't want to give his name, because that's the most sensitive point, you see. I don't want to give them ammunition against me. I don't want really to sort of annoy them till the end, because that's what they hate. But privately, I can tell it to you, you see. So I was so bitter when he said about Russian language, you see. First he said, well, it's too much schoolwork, I will not do it. And then I asked him again, he said, well, you see, teacher still put too much demands, she does not understand that I'm not as I was before. Because he got private teacher coming to him, not as I was before. So all these things is shattered, you see. he's been treated not bad, just hanging around with children in a park. That's all what he's doing. He got some sort of wall around him, like other kids, exactly this, like wall, because they gave him this idea that nothing could be changed anyway, so he became quite bitter and just decided to accept it and just carry on. Same like other children in care. Now they are trying to be covered by him, saying that he doesn't like my protests. That's what he allegedly said to Guardian. Not that he doesn't like it, he doesn't want to know about my protests, but it's all like other children. Problem is that he is not informed, he does not know what is going on. Well, Natalia, you wouldn't believe it. There are so many kids who not even accept it. They don't want to see their children anymore, their parents. This horrifies me utmost. Absolutely horrifies me. So many cases. I know personally. That's the most awful thing what they do. And they fight and fight and fight. So, okay, what is your next move? Medway Council, put me to prison, put me tag on my leg. It's absolutely fine, all in the public domain. My friends will distribute it tenfold more. So just carry on. See, is this injunction? They don't even give open hearings. They tend to keep it in the closed family court. Yeah, monsters. Yes, I know, Natalia, monsters. But complaining and swearing, it's I just used to it. See? Children simply getting switched off their brains. And they simply not all, of course, but a lot of them not interested to see their parents. So on Wednesday we'll have a discussion, four times a year, but I mean Guardian took of course side of local authorities, so four times a year. And if Eugene even want to think about increasing of contacts, he must change his behavior. So it's very simple. If I accept he will stay in care, maybe I will get some more, but it's very doubtful. But I'm not after increasing of contacts. It's all very simple. Three professionals didn't find any Holocaust trauma in me or any other trauma, any other problems. So that's it. Just let my son go. Change of circumstance. It's become so absurd, you can't imagine, that one judge gives an order a year ago to decrease contacts because I spoke about UN Convention of Children's Rights. Nice. Social worker breached even this order. Another judge praise the social worker. It's absolutely insane. It looked like, let's call the court people. You mean to give their names? Yes, there is no any secret about it. No, they injuncted me about people, but it is absurd because, to my view, BC Acharu, she shouldn't work in this place at all. She breached court order of Judge Skarat, who will be on this hearing on Wednesday. Judge Skarat said certain timetable of contacts, and 8th of September, she simply did not make this contact. What means view of a Judge Skarat? Just nothing. Social worker rules. And I'm sure their barrister will always find a way around it, okay? Her manager, Bola Samuel, supervisor, Sarah Cahill. You see, it's so miserable, I mean, and these people, this misery should really rule my son what he should do, what he should not do. Who else? Well, Guardian, Rob Cooper, at least he has some manners, but I already put video about my conversation with him. So no way, Eugene, no way you will see your son more than four times a year, just in this room, and that's what you should accept, just, you know. Yes, it is vulnerable age. Yeah, I understand all that, I understand. But it's so absurd, these things. Yeah, this is a hunger strike, say, sir. Yeah, it's me. I'm on a hunger strike. Are you working for the ministry? Yes. Can they ask you?
Yes.
Well, you see, sir, this is absolutely. I mean,
I will.
Right, I'm just. It was gentleman from the ministry, but he said he was just accountant. But it's okay. It's okay. I didn't want he be filmed. Maybe he wouldn't like it. Yes, vulnerable age. You're right. I mean, I feel so sorry that it's incredible. You see, but I mean, he just tries to avoid troubles. Maybe they scold him for these troubles. They blame him that I am protesting. That's what I'm absolutely sure. People can say he could run away. He could call me on that. Yeah, but he is afraid. I will call Dad one time, and then Dad will make stories, and they will scold me. And what I will get? If my daddy could take me back, he would already done it. He talks, and just nothing. Yes, you're right. You're right, Natalia. You're right. But I mean, we all know about that, you see? So I just think about my next move, because they will make some surprise on Wednesday, you see? So disgusting all that. I wish I could get more people on Wednesday to court hearing, but as usual, Lisette Willekens will come from Belgium for the court hearing. Maybe someone from UK can also come to support me, but almost always alone. Few people, thank you Romanian people that you support me a lot, and Russian people gave me also support, but Romanians came to my actions, some of them, and stayed near me when I was protesting. I will not give up. I will not give in. The worst thing, they're using children against parents. That's their main weapon, you see. They can tell God knows what to my child, you see. So disgusting. So 7 days hunger strike, genuine hunger strike, will be confirmed by doctor, like it was in Strasbourg. But I decided that I'm going just to stay all the time here because I have to do this paperwork. But I can feel my strength is going away. Doctor asked me actually today, he said so far it's okay, but he asked me how long I'm going to continue. Because after 12 days in Strasbourg, I started to deteriorate. Okay. So difficult all that. Yes, thank you, John Love, you're watching. Maybe some British parents can sort of stay around near me. Well, they actually were. There were few people who came. No, Kelvin kindly come. It was another gentleman. Barry came on my court hearing. He was present on the court hearing. Yes, there some people are coming. Жаль. What? Who is it? Ah, it's Alexandra. Yeah, I'm really a bit of tired to type all in Russian now, because I cannot share even. I can only share on my wall, you see. Thank you, Russian friends who do not forget me. He's already 16 months in care. Hi, Simona. Hi, Monica. Well, I will stay here up to 5 or 6 and we'll wait till Wednesday. If they only dare not to allow Dutch embassy to attend. That's what I would like really just to see. If they dare not to let Dutch embassy to attend court hearing. Because solicitor wrote a letter that judge will allow only the best interest of the child. They are just shit their pants, you see. So what I will do next? I mean, maybe take sleeping bag and come to RCJ, make an appeal if they will make this not happen, and just will go to RCJ. I will think of what I will do, because Medway Council will be watching that. Nothing will stop me. They can do whatever they want. Anything would come bad from word of mouth of my child, I will not believe anyway. It's so easy to brainwash children at his vulnerable age, indeed. He just, not that he accepted that, but he thinks that all what father does only bring troubles. All his protests, all these things doesn't give any results, so better he just accept it. So afraid, people so afraid of publicity. Injunction, 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 prison, injunction, prison. So disgusting all that. Okay, let them put me to prison. Just crazy parents have to fight for such uniform. Yeah, Alina, but you see, they really don't care much about Facebook, those people. The only exception if it's really, really massive case, like a Bodnario case. Like a Bodnario case. And tens of thousands came to streets in 30 towns, 32 towns. No one can repeat it, definitely. I would say British parents could be more active. They could come much more. Because it's their country, they should try to do something about it if they feel like that, you see. But as a foreigner, I cannot judge about what British people should do. So let British people decide themselves what they are up to. I know that in Medway there is the not acceptable, yes, at all. So just please what I ask you to do, my friends in groups, and I know you wanted to do it yourself without me asking you even. Maybe it will help. Just feel a bit of, busy, like just weak. It was easier in Strasbourg, actually. Maybe weather was, air was better. But I can't believe it, that I have to less contacts than hardened criminal with my son. I take this hearing like, make more contacts and just move on to discharge this order. They don't want it. And say, Eugene, everyone is against you, IRO officer, so-called independent reviewing officer, you see. Guardian, social worker, and they will put judge also. So disgusting that. Okay, I made an appeal to Medway Council, to Anne Domini. This issue will not go away. Petition is online with the all details about private companies, etc. So if you want to carry on, I will carry on as well. It will be very difficult to, I don't think it will be even possible to stop me in any ways. Hi, Juliet. Allowed to get away with this. I hope you get away with it. I mean, listen, they get away with it in many other cases, you see. So they just used that they are beyond control. I cannot say they are always wrong, because maybe some cases when they are right, I don't know. But I mean, there are so many cases when people are bitterly complaining about that. And it is just amazing how judge listens to social work. It's absolutely incredible. In a contract year ago, he simply didn't make any fact finding, just accept all what they said, and that was it, you see. Didn't want to listen to me, even. Absolutely not. absolutely. Judge Skarat. So the same judge Skarat will be on Wednesday, will decide how many meetings I should have with my son. 4, 6, or 10. 10. But what's the right they have to prevent child and father to see each other? On which grounds? On which grounds I bring emotional harm? I bring emotional harm on the grounds that not accept he's in a foster placement. And I always try to undermine his placement. It means I bring him emotional harm. That's why I cannot see him, you see? Yes, you're right. You're right. Julieta, you're right. They know people for years, for 10, 15 years at the same place, you see. Having receptions together, having lectures together, you see. But this is really mind-boggling, this total isolation. The child's scared to make a phone call or send email. I mean, I cannot come to his school. All at his best interests. Not to undermine foster. Oh, Eugene, make protests? How you think your child will feel about that? How he will feel about that, you see? No way they will break me. No way. It's still, I would appeal to my friends to do what I ask to do. And what you want to do, just write to the judge, email him, call them, these people. Just show that I'm not alone. The more calls and emails, the better we'll be, you see. Dutch embassy wanted to come to hearing only because there were quite a lot of emails and Julieta, that's what you know already, you see. I didn't tell them because they will just jump on me that I'm disclosing his name. But I'm not. People just know him already. It become beyond any normality. I'm like talking with the mad people, you see. Don't speak about this, just keeping play chess. See, like I'm really like in some sort of detention center. And they are so sure they will get away with everything, what's it? Untouchable, invincible, you see. Actually, it will not. I don't think that they will stop paying too much money, because so what? They will waste all this money. I know what why it's so easy to become foster care in this country. See, in the US you have to study at, you know, in special schools. I spoke, have to study this foster care maybe about 6 months, have serious examinations. Here you have spare room, go ahead, you can be a foster care. But trick is that cares are under control of social services. And they are controlling them with money. That's what I can understand. And if you are against, how dare you just be against all of us? You're against system. You're against system again. You just accept, shut up, and just accept your child isn't care. That's what you should do. That's what all people do. All normal good parents see your child 4 times a year, like some distant relatives, and just shut up. It can be that they really so cares to keep my child there, just simply, not simply as that, I don't know what is beneath such a vehemence, just to keep him in, to keep him in care, to keep him by any chance. It's about, I think, 480 people, children in care. I think they just want to prove that they have a last word. they want just to prove me something. Nothing to prove. Thank you, my Romanian friend. Thank you very much. You are really very special people. I'm much grateful to you. Doamne ajută. All the best. And just kindly ask you just to help me to do what I asked. Thank you so much to everybody.